Chapter 1, Monkey Trouble, written by Ruskin Bond. He is one of India's best loved storytellers. Monkey Trouble is one of his many stories about an unusual pet. So let's start this interesting story. Grandfather bought Tutu from a street entertainer for 10 rupees. The street entertainer had 3 monkeys with him, in which Tutu was the smallest one but the most mischievous monkey. That's why she was tied up most of the time. The little monkey looked so miserable with a collar and a chain that Grandfather thought she would be much happier in our home. Grandfather liked to keep unusual pets. At first, Grandmother refused to have a monkey in the house because there was already enough pets in the house, like a goat, several white mice and a small tortoise. So Grandfather said that I don't have any monkey. Then Grandmother replied that you are mischievous enough for 2 monkeys. One boy in the house is all I can take. Oh, but Tutu isn't a boy. Grandfather said that Tutu isn't a boy. This is a little girl monkey. So Grandfather gave permission because she had always wanted a little girl in the house. She believed that girls were less mischievous than boys. But this time Tutu was going to prove her wrong. So let's see how she was going to prove her wrong. As you know that Tutu was a pretty little monkey. Her bright eyes sparkled with mischief. She had a big smile which showed her pearly white teeth and terrified Aunt Ruby. The first thing that Tutu was taught to do was to shake hands, and she supposed to do it this with everyone. Major Malik would have to shake hands with Tutu before he could enter the drawing room. Otherwise, Tutu would climb onto his shoulder and stay there playing with his hair and mustache. Her tail worked as a third end and added to her good looks. Aunt Ruby was not informed of Tutu's arrival. So all of them heard a loud shriek from her bedroom and went running towards her room to see what was wrong. It was Tutu who was wearing Aunt Ruby's petticoats. And all that Aunt Ruby could see was white bundle with no face jumping up and down on the bed. Then Uncle Benji complained that his hairbrush was missing. The speaker found Tutu sunning herself with the hairbrush to scratch her armpits. So the speaker took the hairbrush from Tutu and gave it back to Uncle Benji. And he also said sorry to Uncle Benji, but he threw the brush away. The speaker said Tutu doesn't have fleas and she used to take bath daily. One day, Grandfather had to visit Meerut to collect his railway pension. So he decided to take Tutu and the speaker along with him. To prevent Tutu from moving about on the train, Grandfather kept her in a large black traveling bag. And after that, Grandfather bought 2 tickets. One for himself and another for the speaker. And Tutu was carried inside a large traveling bag. There was enough space in that bag so that he could feed bananas and biscuits to Tutu. But she could not get her hands through the opening or bite open the bag. But as soon as he reached the gate, Tutu poked her head out of the bag and grinned widely at the ticket collector. The ticket collector was surprised. He said, "Sir, you have a dog with you. You will have to buy a ticket for it." But Grandfather was very angry with him and he said that this is not a dog and this is a baby monkey and there is no charge for babies. But the ticket collector said, "Sir, it's a big as a cat, so you have to pay for it. So grandfather and ticket collector started to argue with each other. Grandfather said that a young monkey was not the same as a dog or a cat. But the ticket collector was not ready to listen, and he said to grandfather that you have to pay 5 rupees as Tutu's fare. Then grandfather paid 5 rupees as Tutu's fare, and just to teach the ticket collector a lesson for being unfair with him, he took out a tortoise from his pocket and said that what must I pay for this also. Then the ticket collector gave a triumphant, that means happy and proud look to the grandfather and said that there is no charge for this tortoise, sir, because it is not a dog. We have completed the explanation part of this chapter. Now you have to write meanings and summary of this chapter in your classwork copy. So first of all, what you will do, you will mention date. After that, you will write chapter number and chapter's name. Chapter's name is Monkey Trouble. And writer's name. Writer's name is what? Ruskin Bond. After that, you will paste a picture, or you can draw also. You can draw the picture of monkey. And then on the new page, you will write summary of this chapter. The summary is, in this way you have to start. This story is written by Ruskin Bond. It is about a grandfather's adventurous hobby to keep animals like goat, white mice, and a small tortoise. He bought a female monkey from a street entertainer. It was named Tutu, and she created a chaos at home. After writing this summary, you will underline it and you will come to the next page. On the next page, what you will write, you have to write the meanings of this chapter. So first of all, you will write at the top meanings, and then first one is your mischievous, and on the other side you will write the meaning of mischievous. So the meaning of mischievous is naughtily or annoyingly playful. What you will write? Naughtily or annoyingly playful. The second one is terrified. Meaning of terrified is frightened very much. After writing this, come to the third one. Third one is your green. G-R-I-N, green. Meaning of green is smile broadly. What you will write? Smile broadly. Fourth is miserable. Miserable. Meaning of miserable is very unhappy. What you will write? Very unhappy. Now coming to the fifth one. Fifth one is your unusual. Unusual. Meaning is uncommon. After that, sixth one is your sunning. Meaning of sunning is sitting or lying in the sun. Coming to the seventh one. Seventh one is your taken aback. Taken aback means surprised or shocked. Eighth one. Eighth one is your in vain. In vain, or meaning of in vain is your useless. Ninth one. Ninth one is indignantly. Indignantly means anger at something unfair. Meaning is anger at something unfair. Last one is triumphant. Meaning is happy and proud. After completing this, you just underline it. Now let's move on to the question and answer.
Now here are the assignments that you have to do in your homework copy. First one is here that you have to write a paragraph about an hour spent with a pet, in which you can write whose pet it is, what kind of pet it is, name of the pet, how it looks and what did it do, how is it, was it funny, sweet or clever. In this way you can write it, and just write only near about 10 to 15 lines. Now next, what you have to do is you have to describe in one or two sentences the place where you live and mention the important landmarks on the way, and be sure about the left and right sides. Next that you have to do in your homework is make sentences. Five words are given. You have to make sentences using them. First one is your pretty. Second is your thought. Third, enough. Fourth, inside. And last one is your argue. This all you have to do in this assignment, you have to do in your homework copy. And then after that, we will move on to the next chapter.